Welcome, beautiful souls. Today I would like to share with you a galactic astrology reading for a dog. In this case, this galactic astrology reading is an homage for the dog because she died 2 months ago. But first of all, I would like to say that from the perspective of the galactic astrology, there's no difference between a dog, a cat, or a human, for example, or there's no difference for any kind of being, because first of all, we enter into the Akashic records of the soul. We enter into the realm of the soul. And the soul has no frontiers. The soul has no forms, has no shapes. So a soul can incarnate into different kind of beings, even can be incarnated simultaneously in different kind of beings, in different realms. But for example, as in this case, the reading is for a dog. After we enter the Akashic records of the soul, then little by little, the dog part is projected and we follow this thread, we can say. So saying that, let's begin. We begin with the colors of her soul. Her soul has a rainbow color. So in reality, she has the 7 colors of the rainbow, but all of them working as one. In this way, the rainbow color is a very special color for a soul. It means that the being, in this case Lama, is able to anchor pure joy and playfulness, that she's adventurous and brave, smart, adaptable, eager to learn, curious, sociable, and she uplifts the energies around her wherever she is, and also gives the ability to be a bridge between heaven and earth. This color is a primordial color of her soul, because sometimes colors can change over time, but not is the case, and nor was the case of Honey Bear. About the origins of her soul. In reality, she's part of a vast soul originated in the archangelic realm. An archangelic realm but sustained these planes of consciousness that are very high, around the 11th, 12th densities. In this case, these realms are sustained by the Andromeda galaxy. And this archangelic soul, you can imagine, is vast, is grand, representing the will and power of the primordial source. It's like the will and power of the primordial source in movement, the archangelic realm, I mean. So, this archangelic soul wanted to get closer to the human realm while experimenting the animal realm. So in this way, part of it was projected into the dog matrix, and this part of the archangelic soul projected into the soul matrix became a dog. And the original soul, the archangelic soul, remains in these higher realms of the Andromeda galaxy, although it descended a little bit of dimensions, and now it is in the 9th density, more or less. But also, part of it was projected or focused, in reality is the same, focused part of its energy to the Earth, and in particular to the inner Earth. And here as a wisdom keeper, but a wisdom keeper related to the animal and nature, as a way to remind humans that in reality we are one with all animals, with all nature. And well, as a dog, Lama in this case, this part of the archangelic soul, as a dog, she had few lives here on this galaxy, and she's a bearer of joy and playfulness. She's born wherever she's needed to bring joy and playfulness to the humans around her. She's also a bearer of light, as I said before, also about Honey Bear. Both of them are bearer of lights, showing the way ahead to people that had lost confidence in themselves. She has a light warrior energy, deeply connected to the primordial source through the archangelic realm in this case. And this connection is also working its way through the great attractor, because Honey Bear and Lama has their sons conjunct the great attractor. Remember that the great attractor is the attractor side of the super big cluster of galaxies that we call Laniakea, although there's another one, the super cluster of galaxies, that is the Shapely attractor, super cluster, but the great attractor is a very powerful point that acts as a magnet. So when we have the great attractor conjunct, in this case the sun as Lama and Honey Bear, it means that their light, their potential is really connected to the, not only to the great attractor, but is really connected to their own source, to their own origins, and they are channeling ceaselessly their own potential. In this way, she has given the ability of not fearing the situations around, but accompanying her owners, giving them hope and keeping them connected to the light. She also incarnated, once she entered into this galaxy, she incarnated in the Orion zone, in the Orion constellation, and she was part of the dog people. For me, at least part of the dog people in Orion is more about wolf people, or wolf humanoids, we can say. She, among them, was a wise elder. not a warrior. And they, as a tribe, they helped some human civilizations to escape from their planet and go elsewhere as a way to preserve their life and have the chance to begin anew during the Orion Wars. So it was a way to help them to escape from the greys and the reptilians. But in one of these missions, she was taken captive and brought to the Lyran Nebula, because within the Lyran Nebula at that moment there were the headquarters of the Nebu Empire, the Grey Empire. And they took her with the intention of transform her into a cyborg and then be used for their own benefit, of course. But she always kept her connection with her own source, with her own soul, higher self, we can say. She kept her connection with her heart, so she didn't lose hope. And finally, she was rescued. But the rescue mission was very delicate, we can say, because the first idea was to beam her up into the ship, avoiding direct contact with the Grey Empire, with the Greys that were there, protecting all the headquarters. But it was not easy. So finally, after studying the kind of fence, the kind of protection of that place where she was, they were able to rescue her when she was about to taken into another gray ship to a new facility. So she was rescued. Then she spent some time in Lyra, because once rescued, the beings brought her to the Lyra constellation among humans. And she spent some time there in the Lyra, recovering from the traumatic experience in a planet that was shared between humans and also dog people. At that moment, she wanted to return to Orion, to her own tribe, but it was not possible for the war. So, realizing that the only way left for her was to go on and open a new way of life, a new path for her future, she accepted her condition, the place, the situation. She accepted it. So she stayed at that planet for the rest of her life at that moment. After dying, her soul reincarnated again one more time into the Lyra constellation. In this case, was in a planet orbiting the star Alatfar, and also part of a dog people community, where in this case he lived peacefully with his family and his community. It was a peaceful life. Then he incarnated, we can say, in the Aquila constellation, also being a dog that was part of the darter humans, or humanoids, we can say, the darter civilization. The Darter have a peculiarity, and is their lifespan is very short, is about 40 human years. So imagine for a dog, the lifespan is shorter with them. But is a way they are there to increase the frequency, the frequencies in general, of the Altair star system, because in Altair live very, we can say, malevolent beings, humans and non-humans. So the Darter in particular are there to help to uplift the energies, so the star system cannot collapse into a more dense reality. They live in the sixth density, and also then she incarnated in the Ophiuchus constellation on a planet inhabited by a human civilization in progress of developing a more advanced technology and consciousness, similar to the humans now. There was a particularity with this human civilization, because they shared the planet with other human civilizations, but less advanced than them. So the less advanced civilizations didn't understand why they have to build some kind of buildings, some kind of technology. And because of that, they create problems from time to time. So this human civilization that is toward more advanced consciousness have to dwell from time to time from the others, less advanced. In particular, for example, one thing that I perceive, what I was connected with the Akashic records of Lama, was that once they began to construct elevated buildings, and the other civilizations wanted to destroy those buildings because they didn't understand why the purpose of a big and high building, a tall building. So finally, the civilization where Lama was incarnated was able to create some kind of protection, or fence, we can say, around their lands, and finally they could keep the others apart, and could continue evolving without dwelling with the other ones. And Lama was part of them. But at that moment, she was part of the children, to keep them in joy, playing with them, in spite of the current incursions of the other civilizations. And from time to time, also, this civilization also was menaced by other space-faring civilizations from the nearby constellations. So her purpose there was uplifting, keeping the energy of joy and playfulness alive in spite of these kind of situations. Then she incarnated in Epsilon Eridanus, in the constellation of Eridanus, part of a human civilization. one moment. Yeah, at that moment, the Eridanus beings were about to create a very special place, a very special library, a living library, not only for them, but for all beings that have enough consciousness to enter into this living library, and in this way learn, or maybe we can say perceive, assimilate, integrate the learnings that the living library were given to them. This living library was very special because it was made by flowers, living flowers, of course, flowers with consciousness, that if you sit near one of them, you can communicate with them, or they can communicate with you and bring you wisdom, knowledge, the one you need at the moment. And this garden, we can say, they created it together with other beings, with other humanoids. For example, the Katai from Sirius A helped them, but also the Kilimat R, that are from the Crux constellation, also helped them to create this flower library. And Lama, at that moment, was involved as a dog, was involved in this awakening, in this creation, using sound and light codes, and also light geometry. So, yeah, because although humans or humanoids created this special garden, but in reality, many different species participated in this creation, and one of them were the dogs, and in particular, Lama. Because the humanoid beings in Epsilon Eridanus consider, feel in reality, that nature is sacred, and wanted to honor it more, creating this library, but also that different species, different animals could participate in this creation. After that life, that beautiful life, Lama's soul incarnated on Tau Ceti. On Tau Ceti as a dog among humans, the Aramani, the same humanoids or humans than Honeybird incarnated before coming to Earth. And she was involved in some missions to Earth as a way to begin to know, to perceive, to adapt to the Earth environment, to the Earth gravity, also density, the particular density of the Earth. And until one day an Aramani, a human priest, saw that the future of Lamas was on Earth, among humans, because her energy was much needed here. So they helped her to prepare and adapt herself to the new planet, and that's why they took her here from time to time to adapt her. After that, she was able to begin to incarnate here on Earth. She incarnated just before the World War II in a German colony on South Africa. There she brought light to his owners at that moment that were having difficult time, uncertainty. They were also with a deep sadness within. And after that life, she incarnated in Zimbabwe. And now we're going to talk about her death, about her death chart. About her death.
For a moment.
For example, the sun, her sun, was conjunct the point of fortune and Salacia, meaning and at this point where the sun was at that moment, the Sabian symbol is a teacher give new symbolic forms to traditional images, meaning that it was a time for new ideas, new messages to spread. Look at things from a different perspective, even opening to new dimensions of consciousness. And at that moment, she really took this context, these energies, this window of energy of that moment to take a leap forward and left her body and entered into new states of consciousness, new realms to explore, to learn. It was a moment that her sparks of light were in a perfect balance with her purpose here on Earth in this life. It was a perfect balance and also a big window allowing her to leap forward. It was like, your purpose is done. Now you can move on. And she took the advantage of that with strength, courage, that Aries means, and she leapt to the unknown. For example, at that moment, her vertex, the vertex, it means a changing point. The vertex was really conjunct with Saturn in Pisces. It means that really it was the right moment to move into new directions, into new states of consciousness, Pisces. And yeah, moving towards them. And in this way, she led embracing more the entire universe, yeah, the different higher consciousness. And that's it for today. So have a wonderful day, plenty of love and light. See you soon.